For the Jakarta release of ServiceNow, the report designer was enhanced to make it easier to create and share reports. This video will guide you through the process of creating a new report in the report designer. Here, we're logged in as the system administrator. First, let's go to the reports application. From the reports list, we can see reports created by the logged in user, reports that are shared by specific groups or users, reports that are shared as global, and all reports that are accessible for the logged in user to view. To create a new report, we could open the Create New module or click here. You can also create a report from other places in your instance, like creating a widget from your dashboard. But for this example, we'll start from the Report module. First, let's give our report a name. This is a mandatory field. It is important to give your report a name that's logical and clear. In this scenario, let's call our report Incident Priority. Next, we'll select a source type. You can create a report from a data source or a table. Here's the difference. When using a table as the source, the report creator must provide all the conditions for each report, even if many of the conditions are the same from one report to another. But a report source defines a standard set of conditions for querying a particular table, which can be reused in other reports. Note that in the report designer, report sources are called data sources. So let's select data source as the source type. Next, we'll select the data source for open incidents. If there's already a report based on that data source, a message will tell you so. You can see a list here. It's a good idea to check because the report you're creating might already exist. But not this time. Let's go back to our report and move on to the next step. With the first three fields set, we click Next, which advances us to the Type tab. Be aware that you can jump to any part of the report designer by clicking the tabs at the top, or navigate by clicking back or next. Here, under the Type tab, choose the format for your report: bar charts, pie charts, time series, multidimensional, and lots more. You can point to each type to get more information. For our report, let's choose a simple bar chart. And here's our incident data. Easy! The data is displayed in the selected type of visualization, in this case, a bar chart. But we want to refine our report, so let's group the data by priority. We can then refresh the report by clicking Next, Run, or the refresh icon. Now we see a visualization of all the active incidents, but they're grouped by priority. When we're happy with the way the data is displayed, we can go on to the Style tab to change the size, colors, and other visual aspects. There are various options available to help you customize the visualization of your report. We have a good selection of colors to choose from, but let's give this bar chart some color variations to set the data apart. We'll choose the color palette. Now let's refresh. Okay, our report looks great, so let's save it. And now our report is ready to use and share. Here, we select how to share our report. You can also schedule a report to be run and shared via email, add a report to a dashboard, export it to PDF, or publish or unpublish it. The suggested option is to share with different groups or users, to add meaningful reports to your dashboards, and of course, publish. You can also schedule the report to be run and shared via email. Exporting to PDF is also an option, but remember that when you export to PDF, you lose the benefit of sharing real-time information. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.